feel like you have, because his power is working in you. You see, God is up to something so big, so unimaginably good, that your mind cannot contain it. We can't even begin to comprehend the great things that God has in store for us. But we have to let him in. We have to experience him. We have to be part of that. We have to put our hand in his hand. We have to taste the Lord. You know, what we see God doing is never as good as what we don't see. Think about that a minute. We've seen God do amazing things in our lives and the people's lives around us. We've seen God's people accomplish amazing things, but that's nothing compared to what we don't see, to what God's doing, say, behind the scenes. We can't even begin to imagine how wonderful those blessings are. And the only way we can truly accept it, the only way we can truly have this kind of faith, understanding, I'm going to live my life for God, is by tasting God and seeing that he is good. And once we truly taste God, we'll want to devour all that he has to offer. I'm sure you've been there. You've went to someone's house or maybe to a buffet, and they had something on there you wanted to try. And so you went up and you tasted it. And it was good. It was amazing. And so what'd you do? I want more. I want more. And if you're like most of us, you kept going back until you could eat no more. That's the way we need to be with God. We need to get it filled up with God. But the amazing thing is, we can fill up with God and never be fooled, because it's a desire we're always going to have. We're just going to draw closer and closer and closer to him. And the closer we get to God, the more that we get to know God, the more we want to know God, the more we want to know about God, the more we want to be like him in every way that we can. So we taste the Lord and see that he is good. And then we devour all that he has to offer. There is a promise that goes along with this. In the second part of Psalm 34 and verse 8, it says, "Blessed is the man who takes refuge in him." Remember, that word blessed, when referring to man, means happy. Happy is the man who takes refuge in God. You want to be happy? Take refuge in God. Give God your life. God wants to be our protector. We need to allow him to do that. So we can take refuge in him. We can be happy in that. We can understand, again, that he's going to take away all fear. I mean, how much happier can we get if we've got nothing to fear? Think about that. Let's give it to God. Take refuge in God takes a change of mindset, because we're taught so often in this world that we have to do things ourselves. You know, there's even a proverb that goes around that people claim's in the Bible, but it's not. But it says, God helps those who help themselves. God helps the helpless. So I have to have a change of mindset. As a prideful person, I have to be able to stand before God and say, God, I cannot do it. I need you. I can't protect myself. I need you to protect me. I need you, God, to be my refuge, because I cannot be my own refuge. I've got to give my life to him. I got to change my mindset and be completely humble before him. So what this means to us is that God has to be our focus of our entire life. You know, being a Christian is not about assembling on Sunday morning. I mean, that's an important part of what we do. But being a Christian is about living a certain type of life, focusing on God and serving others. That's got to be our focus. So our focus is on God. That allows us to give Him our life and give in to being a servant to all. But it all depends where our focus is. A fellow by the name of Tom Friends several years ago wrote for the New York Times, and he asked Jimmy Johnson, who at the time was coaching the Dallas Cowboys, what he told his players before heading in to the 1993 Super Bowl. Jimmy said, "I told them that if I took a 2x4 and I laid it on the floor here in the locker room, everybody in this room could walk across it. They wouldn't fall. Because their focus would be walking the length of that board." He said, "But if I take that same board and put it 10 stories high, very few people would make it across because everybody's focus would be on falling instead of making it across." Johnson said, "I told my players not to focus on the crowd, not the media. Don't even focus on the possibility of failing, but focus on each play as if it were a good practice." The Cowboys won that game 52-7. Focus. Focus. That's what we need to do. Focus on God, and we will be victorious. As we mourn not being able to come together, focus on God. We can still communicate. I mean, we can still text, we can email, we can call, we can FaceTime, we can Skype. There's all kinds of ways we can still get together. Here we are together today doing this. But we just need to be focused on God. Paul put it this way in Philippians 4:8. "Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things." And just like we said in the very beginning, God is always praiseworthy. Always think about God. Brings us right back to that original thought. Think about God, for He is praiseworthy. Are you thinking about God all the time? Friends, we know that God is good, or shall I say great. We know that He can do anything. We know, because we've been told, He's going to take away our fear. I mean, we've all witnessed great things that God has done in our own lives, and even in the lives of those around us. So now, it's time to ask ourselves, have I truly tasted God? Have I truly tasted the Lord? If not, make your decision to do so today. You can go to God and you can tell Him you really want to taste Him. You want to work on that relationship. You want to put effort into it. And He'll give you the strength. He'll take away the fears that maybe that's kept you from doing that. If you need to, you can even call up some of your Christian brothers and sisters and pray together if you need to. And you can lift one another up. Right now, I want to go to God in prayer. Father, we thank You so much for being our refuge, for being great, for being wonderful. We thank You for giving us the technology that we have, that we're able to do this. Even though we can't come together in this one room and be together, we can still worship together. We can still hear Your word as a group. Father, You're just amazing. And let us never lose our focus on you. Let us never take our eyes off of you. Let us follow the path that you've laid out before us. And Father, let us remember, we've got nothing to fear. We've got nothing to hold us back. Let us taste the Lord and see that He is good. It's through Jesus we pray. Amen.
Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend, who would have thought that a lamb could rescue the souls of men? Oh, you rescue the souls of men. Counselor, Comforter, Keeper, Spirit we long to embrace. You offer hope when our hearts have hopelessly lost the way. Oh, we've hopelessly lost the way. You are the one that we praise. You are the one we adore. You give the healing and grace our hearts always hunger for. Oh, our hearts always hunger for. Almighty, infinite Father, faithfully loving your own, here in our weakness you find us falling before your throne. Oh, we're falling before your throne. You are the one that we pray. Forgive, O Lord, and heal our land, and give us eyes to seek your face and hearts to understand that you alone make all things new. And the blessings of the land we love are really gifts from you. If my people will humbly pray and seek my face and turn away from all their wicked ways, then I will hear them and move my hand and free. And I will heal them. And
unite our hearts.
Unite our hearts
in one accord.
In one accord. Make us hungry for your peace and burden for the poor. And grant us hope.
And grant us hope
that we might see. The future for the land we love, our life, our liberty. If my people will humbly pray and seek my face and turn away from all their wicked ways, then I will hear them and move my hand and freely forgive, and I will heal their land. God of our fathers, whose almighty hand leads forth in beauty of a starry band, of shining worlds in splendor through skies, our grateful songs before the in the past. In this remand by thee our lot is cast. Be thou our ruler, guardian, guide, and stay. Thy word our law, thy path our chosen way. O beautiful for men of faith who founded this great land, proclaim for us in God we trust and help to God's strong hand. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, till lives confess his righteousness. From sea to shining sea, if my people will humbly seek my face and turn away from all their wicked ways, then I will hear them and move my hand, and freely then will I forgive, and I will heal them.
Sovereign.